Honorable Chairman, sir, I consider it my privilege to be able to speak on the company's Amendment Bill 2020. I'm immensely grateful to you for giving me this opportunity. At the outset, let me offer my compliments to Honorable Prime Minister Modi and the Finance Ministry for taking this bold and much needed step to amend the Companies Act to 2013. With this amendment, the central government has proved that it is not only responsive to the changing requirements of the business community in the country, but it is also capable of taking timely and effective decision in this time of crisis. This amendment will promote and encourage ethical business practice in the country and reinforce the belief of common men in economic value creation. Sir, this amendment will result in ease of doing business, honest business, and in ease of doing ethical business. Now, sir, let me go back to the sequence of events. I just want to apprise the House about the sequence of events leading to the placement of this bill today in this August House. Sir, as all of us know, the Companies Act 2013 was enacted on 29th August 2013 to consolidate and amend the law relating to companies. The earlier Companies Act, the Companies Act of 1956, had been repealed. And as told by my learned colleague in the opposition, there were different amendments at different points of time. There were amendments in 2015, in 2017, and 2019. But these amendments took place because these amendments had to address the difficulties arising out of the operation of the Act. When the government sees that there are operational problems when a particular act is being implemented, it's the 2013 Act, we should remember. There were operational issues, and that is why amendments had to be brought in. And that is why amendments are being brought in today when I'm speaking to you. Sir, now let me tell you the entire sequence of events. As I mentioned earlier, the government, led by Honorable Prime Minister Modi, has been constantly endeavoring, and it's all written in the wall, and everybody is aware of it. He has been constantly endeavoring to facilitate greater ease of living for all, including the law-abiding corporates. I underscore, for all, including the law-abiding corporates. The government constituted the Company Law Committee on 18th of September 2019 under the chairmanship of the then Secretary Corporate Affairs. And so the best part is that in that particular committee, there were eminent people from different segments, from different sectors. There were people from industry chambers, there were people from professional institutes, and there were people from legal fraternity. This particular committee has been constituted to actually decriminalize penal provisions. This is the basic aim of this amendment, decriminalize penal provisions of Companies Act 2013 based on their gravity and take other concomitant measures to provide further ease of living for law-abiding corporates in the country. So this committee submitted its report after due deliberation on 18th of November 2019 before the government. Now, the Department of Company, the Corporate Affairs, actually submitted a note before the Union Cabinet on 10th of December 2019. I'm harping on the sequence of events to say, to emphasize, to dwell on the fact that government has duly considered all these steps. Government has actually gone for stakeholder consultations. Government has gone for all kinds of thinking through exercises, and then it has come up with the proposal for amendment. So interestingly, when it was sent to the Union Cabinet, there were two group of ministers meeting. It was not just cleared with the Cabinet at one go without much consideration. The Union Cabinet desired two GOM. So there were two groups of ministers meetings, and this group of ministers' meetings, these two meetings, actually went into each of the provisions that had been recommended for amendment. The Union Cabinet considered and approved the proposal to introduce the Companies Amendment Bill on 4th March 2020. Now, as per the decision of the Union Cabinet, the bill today prepares to carry out amendments to 72 sections of the Companies Act 2013, and the bill was brought in this Lok Sabha by the Honorable Finance Minister on 17th March 2020. I reiterate, the sequence of events indicate that there has been considerable deliberation, considerable thinking through, and considerable stakeholder consultations before the amendments have been brought today to the House. Now, sir, the question is, what are the key changes that are being proposed by this particular bill, and what would be the benefits that would be accruing if these amendments are actually implemented on the ground? I would be categorizing all the amendments that have been suggested, that have been proposed, under seven different heads. Please give me some time. I'm the first speaker. I would be just elaborating on some of the key changes and the benefits thereof. It's very important for this August House to appreciate and understand the kind of benefits that would be coming to us. So first, it empowers the central government to exclude certain companies from the definition of listed companies. Section 2 of the bill amending Section 2 of the Act, I'm referring to the section that will be amended of the Act of 2013. Now, what's the present scenario? What would be if this is amended, and what would be the benefit? Sir, Section 252 subsection of the Act 2013 defines a listed company as any company which has any of its securities listed on any recognized stock exchange. Section 42 of the present Act, read with SEBI regulations, Securities and Exchange Board of India regulations, indicates that in addition to public companies, certain private companies too are permitted to list debt securities on a recognized stock exchange. By virtue of being a listed company, the private companies too were required to comply with stringent regulations and compliance requirements mentioned in the Act. These stringent compliance requirements disincentivize the companies from seeking listing of their debt securities. Bahut sare aise company the jo hatotsahit ho rahe the, isliye zaruri tha ki in sab ko unlist kiya jaye, delist kiya jaye. Now, what is the proposal? The amendment bill chooses to exclude or delist certain class of companies from the status of listed companies to unlisted in consultation with SEBI. Very hard work has been put in while drafting this proposal. By virtue of this amendment, the disincentivizing provisions of the Act applicable to other listed companies under the Act can be made inapplicable to such private listed companies. So this is the first key change, and this is what we are going to do once this amendment is accepted by the August House. So number two key change, it proposes the enabling of listing in foreign jurisdiction. Now, a tremendous benefit would accrue if this is done. This is Section 5 of the bill amending Section 23 of the Act. Now, what's the present scenario? The Act of 2013 does not allow the domestic companies to list their securities in stock exchanges in foreign jurisdiction. Neither companies in foreign jurisdiction can do same in India. So, sir, what is the amendment proposed? The bill empowers the central government to allow certain classes of public companies to list permitted securities in stock exchanges in permissible foreign jurisdiction. Permitting the direct listing of debt securities in foreign jurisdiction will help the domestic public companies by offering them a chance to access a larger pool of capital. This is likely to help our startups tap overseas markets to raise capital. Startups are often on the lookout, as we know, sir, to raise capital, and this would permit them to do so without migrating to a foreign jurisdiction. Now, the third and the most important proposal, the key change that we are talking of, that we have been talking of, that I heard my dear friend talking about. decriminalization of offenses. So this amendment bill introduces reforms aimed at decriminalizing offenses based on their gravity. The changes proposed are, I will be listing out four for the knowledge of the House. One, 23 compoundable offenses are now referred to the in-house adjudicating mechanism, IAM as we call it. Number two, it proposes to omit seven offenses which may be dealt with using other laws in force. Number three, it proposes alternate framework for five offenses. And number four, a list of compoundable offenses are restricted to only fine. So the benefit thereof would be this amendment bill proposes to allow the company to pay the penalty, rectify their faults, and become compliant with the law through IAM framework. This will promote ease of doing business. In fact, this is what the fear is all about. Why are we decriminalizing? People will be going scot-free. Corporates will be going scot-free. That's what has been raised. I was just listening to my dear friend. Sir, this will promote ease of doing business. This will boost the confidence of investors. So here I would like to just deviate from what I'm saying. I'll come to the fourth point, but before that, let me tell you that the World Bank report, doing of business report has come. India is 63rd rank. India was 142nd. India has come up to 63rd rank. And this particular result has been due to all kinds of efforts that had been put in by the central government under the dynamic leadership of our Honorable Prime Minister Modi. We have come from 142nd to 63rd, sir. Now the point is, if we are able to amend this particular, we bring in these amendments on the ground, we implement them, definitely our position will improve. Sir, we are moving from good to better and better to best. As we say, good, sir, better, best, never let it rest till your good is better and your better best.
It's a under good concluding sentence.
Prime Minister Modi, we are better, but I'm sure we have to go to the best place, and I'm sure we will be able to do that, and that is why it's very important to have this particular bill implemented on the ground. Sir, I'll just take 2-3 minutes. I'm just putting forward the important issues that I think the House needs to know. Sir, the fourth is the corporate social responsibility. The bill permits a company which spends in excess of the mandated 2% to carry forward the excess spending towards their obligation for the next year, sir. We have already discussed this. This is beneficial in case of CSR initiatives which require higher amount of capital, as this allows the company to invest in the CSR initiative and have the excess being waived off from the CSR obligation arising in the subsequent year. Sir, isse CSR initiative ko bal milega aur companiyon ka utsah badhega, isliye ye karna zaruri hai. Sir, introduction of a new chapter on producer companies, insertion of chapter 21A to the Act of 2013. Sir, benefit to independent directors, in fact, to encourage them.
Don't go to the details.
They would be given awards and they would be brought at par with the, sir, just give me 2-3 minutes. They would be brought at par with the executive directors because they have contributed to the betterment of the company and they should be encouraged.
Please come to the concluding part.
Sir, exactly, sir. This is the seventh key change that I was referring to. I talked of seven key change. Sir, benches of National Company Law Appellate Tribunal, NCLAT, will be set up in order to ease their burden.
It's very difficult to go into all the provisions of the bill. Please.
Sir,
your former sentence was a very good sentence for conclusion.
Sir, in periods like this,
yes,
these are the concluding lines.
Yeah, please.
We have to appreciate from that point of view. In periods like this, when India is struggling to deal with a pandemic of such magnitude, boldness in policy making and deft financial management is the key to recovery. With all conviction at my command, I can say, with all humility too, that this amendment would encourage business, investment, and entrepreneurship in the country. So
Thank
I would
you.
Humbly make an appeal to all my colleagues.